CSS positions are often considered to be extremely confusing, but once you learn about it, you can put an HTML element anywhere in the screen you want. CSS positions are primarily of 5 types: absolute, fixed, static, relative, and sticky. And in this video, we will cover all of this with an interesting example. So let's get right into it. In my VS Code, I have created one index.html file and I have also attached the style.css file. Now in the index.html file, I have one div with the class name of container, and inside let me create few rectangles. So let me give the class name of rect and also the ID of rect starting from 1, and also let's give some text of rect again starting from 1, and let's say I want to create 5 rectangles, so multiply it by 5. So here we have rect 1 to rect 5. Now I will go to my style.css file and I will ignore all the base styles. And I want to give some styles to our rectangle. So I will identify it by .rect. And here, first of all, let's say I want to give a border of 2 pixel solid green. And it is taking the whole width of the container. I want to give the width of 270 pixel. Let's also give the height of 90 pixel. And let's also give some margin of 5 pixel so that it gets some space. And let's give some background color of light green. Let's increase the font size to, let's say, 1.5 rpm. And let's also do a text align center. Yeah, so we have rectangles 1 to 5 aligned as it should be aligned. Now we want to see what are different kinds of positions in CSS. So we will start from absolute. So right now we have rect 1 to 5 aligned vertically. So what happens if I give the rect 1 the position of absolute? So let me give position absolute. As we can see that rect 2 has vanished. And why is that? And that is because the position of absolute actually breaks the rectangle 1 from the normal alignment of the items. So when we have this absolute position, we also have access to 4 more things, and those are top, then bottom, then also left and right. So this top, bottom, left and right is basically how much this rectangle is aligned in the top, bottom, left and right directions. So if I give, let's say, top of 0 pixel, it will go at the top. If I give, let's say, bottom of 0 pixel, nothing will happen because it makes no sense having both top and bottom. So let me just comment bottom and let me give left of 0 pixel, and it's aligned at the left. And we can also do it something like this, let's say minus 100 pixel, and it's gone because we cannot see. Let's give minus 10 and it will go inside. If I give here, let's say minus 100, and as we can see, it's going inside. So this is how basically top, left, bottom, right and all of these things work. And now also one more thing is there, let's say everything is commented out and rect 1 is standing on top of rect 2. So what happens, like how can I show rect 2 instead of rect 1? So in that case, I will use something else called z index, and the z index basically shows that in the direction that is coming outside of my computer, like how the rectangles are aligned. So if I give minus 1, let's say, so we have rect 2. So what happens is by default, everything has a z index of 0. So when I give minus 1, it means that rect 1 is inside of my screen. Like it's a hypothetical situation, but that's how it works. So this is how our absolute property works. Now the second property that we will see is called relative. And also before going there, let's give some reasonable top and let's say left, top and right. Let's give minus 50 and here minus 10. Okay, I think minus 50 pixel, yeah. So I think this is fine. Now we go to relative. So here I will select my rect 2 and let me give a position of relative. And what happens? Nothing happens. So what is the difference between this rect 1, absolute and relative, is that the position absolute breaks it from the normal alignment of the items. It breaks it from the HTML document. But position of relative doesn't do that. So here if I do, let's say, top of 10 pixel, as we can see that it gave little bit space at the top of the document. So it is still inside the document, but we again have the access to all of these things, that is top, right, left, and all of these things. So let me give right of minus 50 pixel, and it just went right side to minus 50 pixel, and so it is not basically taking the right of the screen in that sense. It is only taking what should be considered right from the, like, from its normal position. So if I give let's say left of minus 50, it will go to the opposite side. So that's how it works. So let me give it minus, let's say, 250 towards the right, and that is how our, like, our relative works. And as you can see, since I'm giving minus 250 pixel, the position that rect2 was occupying is still blank, and that means it is not breaking the HTML document. Now the third position type we will see is called static. So let me do rect3 of let's say position, not inherit, that we will see at the end, static. So what happens now? And nothing happens, and that is because static is the default position of elements in HTML. So when we give nothing, no position and nothing, it is static. And here we don't have any access to any top, bottom, or anything. So if I give 50 pixel, nothing will happen, because this top, bottom, and all of these things don't exist for static. Like, it doesn't exist when we give no position. So let's move on to position fixed. So for my rectangle 4, I want to give the position fixed. So let me give position fixed here. And as we can see, that rectangle 5 vanished. So what really happened here is rectangle 5 occupied the position of rectangle 4, and so we don't see rectangle 5 anymore. So position of fixed, like position absolute, also breaks the HTML document, and the element that has the position of fixed is aligned separately. So here once again I can give the, let's say, left of 50 pixel, and it is aligned towards the left little bit, about 50 pixel. So let me give the right of 50 pixel and also the bottom of 50 pixel, and it is aligned somewhere at the, like, bottom right. And now if I scroll down, as you can see, this rectangle 4 is fixed with us. So that is why it is called position fixed. So in many websites you will find one chatbot kind of thing at the bottom right, and to make those kinds of chatbots, you can use the position of fixed. And that is how it is also used quite often. And also you can do some kind of like footer or those kind of things. So here if I do, let's say, width of 100%, and let's remove the right and everything, and let's give a bottom of, let's say, 0 pixel. So it is kind of like one footer. So we also have to give, let's say, margin of 0. And as you can see, it looks somewhat like a footer of this container. So for these reasons also, you can use the position of fixed. And the last position that we want to discuss is called sticky. So sticky is also very similar to our, like, fixed. The only difference is that sticky doesn't break the element from the HTML document. So for the rect 5, let me give a position of sticky. And we don't see any difference, but to get some difference, let me also create few more like rectangles. So here we have 5, let's create 16. So I will once again do dot rect, and then hashtag of rect dollar, and then I will give the value of rect dollar, and let's create 16. And as you can see, the rectangle 5 is still aligned with the, like, normal alignment of the HTML elements. So the position is not broken, but for the rectangle 4, the position is broken. Even if we remove all these three things, you will see that the position of the rectangle 4 is broken and rectangle 5 is occupying its space. Here let me just try to give the Z index of let's say 1. So we can now see rectangle 4 and not the others. And now let's give the remaining, and we have the rectangle 4 footer. So for the rectangle 5 also, we can do the same things. So let's try to create one navbar. So I will give top of 0 pixel, and then we will also give let's say something like width of 100 pixel. So we don't see anything, not 100 pixel, it is 100%. So we don't see anything that this rectangle 5 is at the top or anything. And we will see that actually when we scroll down. So this rectangle 5 is aligned at the top when we are scrolling down. So if I give it, let's say, a top of 10 pixel, it will be aligned little bit, like about 10 pixel from the top. So that is how our basically the difference between our fixed and our sticky. And lastly, we have something called inherit. And inherit is nothing but it basically inherits the position from its parent. So let's say I have my container, and here by default I will have a position of something like position of static. If we have no position, it is basically position of static. And so if I give, let's say, for the rectangle 6 position of inherit, it will be position static by default. But this doesn't make any sense, and that is because we are not able to test it. So let's do something else. So let's say we have rectangle 1, which has a position of absolute. Let's create a child rectangle here. So after rectangle 1, inside, let me create another div of, let's say, rect child, and let's write rect child. So inside we have something called rect child, and now I want to identify the rect child. So here let me write rect child, and here let me give position of inherit. So it has absolute now, absolute position now. So how can we test that? We can test that by writing something like this. Let's say bottom of 100 pixel. And what do you see? And we see that it is gone. It is gone, and we don't see it anywhere. Let's give bottom of 10 pixel, and as you can see, it is aligned little bit lower. If I make it 15 pixel, it is now a little bit higher. Let's make it minus 15, and as you can see, it's going down. So when we give bottom of 100 pixel, it is basically taking the bottom of the rect one, and so it is out of the screen. So instead of that, let's give top of 100 pixel. And as you can see, it is once again gone. Let's try to give z index of 2. And as you can see, it is over this one. So let's give 200. And you can now basically control the left like the rect child. So let's give right of 100 pixel. And now it is over here. So you can basically play around with it. So regarding CSS positions, that's all we need to discuss. There is nothing else. And once you get a good grasp of it, you can basically align anything anywhere in CSS. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and bye bye.